part of family is based on my childhood, and then the other element is about mother and what there is for Margaret. And basically her son is looking after her, and he is like an unsung hero, and she is very nice. But what brings them together is the mother grew up in the 1960s, so she's going to the wizard, Hastings, so she has basically passed it down to Buddy, and so he's into the whole thing. And what happens if you come back in your way is that there's a guy that lives nearby who's out of work with Dolly. And Dolly basically didn't know that Dolly was in Quadrophenia. And he finds out, and basically something special happens. And their world changes by into Dolly. And really from how I mean supported the film. And what I can say about the film is everyone I love behind it. Everyone has seen it. It's ever been my mood, they're in tears. And it's been a beautiful experience. And I'm following it up now with the feature now with both of now. It carries on the same.
And obviously, revisiting this landscape of the 60s in Quadrophenia has brought you into contact with the mob community, as we know it's a very loving and warm community, and they fully embrace this film, haven't they?
And, I mean, without the mobs and their support, this film wouldn't happen. So, for all the BM buddies out there that supported the film, all I can say is, you know, incredible thanks. And it's lovely to tell a story that's positive about also a neurological condition and just wave a flag for my awareness or any neurological condition and say something positive rather than negative. Let's be basic, neurological conditions are depressing. So I want you to make a film that when you left, you took kind of kicking step, you felt good. And it was a positive experience because we need life-affirming films in this world. Because there's not enough out there. We need films that give your spirit back and make you think, yeah, I'm a fighter.
That's fantastic. I mean, it's amazing. 40 years ago, pretty much to this month, a film crew came down there and pretty much were all around these lights here, were actually doing some incredible things. I mean, how's it been revisiting that moment?
I can't remember. No, that's a lot. I get it's an extraordinary thing to be down there a couple of weeks ago. We've just completed a documentary about those days called Our Generation from Very Long Sky Art. So there's a lot of stuff around the 40th anniversary of Quadrophenia. It's quite fitting that Devin's been being is coming out it's 40 years since we actually made the film. It's Brighton has been a warm-hearted film for all of us, and somebody said Brighton wears a fur coat, it's got no drawers. Which I think is an absolute strictly Brighton. Now it's great to be here, it's lovely to be here, and to have celebrated what Devlin has done in his film is a great honour as well.
Because obviously over the years there's been many sort of sequels, Quadrophenia and remakes and whatnot. But what attracted you to being? What was it so special that brought you to?
Well, I was in the theatre doing some work and Devlin said the script for me to spend the door. And the real thing that did it for me is it made me smile. I thought this is such a lovely story. You know, I've played a lot of movies since I've played for a long time, but I've played a lot of drug addicts or criminals or Nazis or whatever. And this is just a lovely story, a lovely story that has made me smile.
So I say, Devin, a final question to you. When you were doing the filming of the Brighton sequences, what was that moment like to see that army of mods embracing your film and as you filmed it along here? And also, as we should say, filmed on the pier as well.
It's not magical, you know, because it's like going back to the mob, that was one point. It was marked and Joshua Bowen were running. And we were laughing, there was just so much joy about that moment. It was like joy with everyone out there that wanted to bring this up at the golf bar. Just everyone was together. Everyone wanted to realise this dream.
A final question from Mark. The mob community is a warm and loving community. Have you experienced that working on this?
Well, without the mob community, this film would never happen because I've never told you the power from it. So I would like to thank all of you that contributed by giving time and your money for such a great, lovely film. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mark Winnick, Kevin Crowe, Phil Dean, as representing this beautiful pack, which will be here forever. Thank you very much.